Yo, what's up? This is Patrick from Guy in the Cube. In this video, I'm gonna show you how to enable query folding on a native query Power BI desktop. Stay tuned. If you find this for the very first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date from all the videos from both Adam and this guy. Okay, earlier this week, I was talking to my friend Alex Powers, and I don't know how we got on the subject of native queries in Power BI Desktop, but he was like, you know you can enable folding. I was like, no you can't. He was like, yes, you can. And he pointed me to some content, and he was like, you know Chris Webb blogged about this. And so I found Chris's blog, and I read about it, and my mind was, because both Adam and I have been telling people, once you go native query, you break query folding. It's just not gonna work. And so if you're not sure about query folding, there's lots of content out there. I think I did a video on it. I'm sure Alex Powers and Chris Webb, they have tons of content out there. You should go check it out, okay? But in this video, I'm gonna show you how to enable query folding when you use a native query in Power BI Desktop. So enough of all this talking. You guys know what I like to do. Let's do what? Let's head over to my laptop. I'm over here in the query editor, and all I'm gonna do is get a native query. I'm gonna use Power BI Desktop to import data with a native query. So I'm just gonna use a recent source that I'm connected to, and check this out. How many of you guys knew you could do this? You see this? This is my database. How many of you guys have ever right-clicked on this and chose transform data? Alex actually showed me this, and I was like, what? Wait a minute. What's gonna happen? First, you get the prompt for import a direct query. Let's go ahead and import. It opens it up and it gives you this table list. And I was like, well, what do I do now? He's like, let me show you something else. See this little function? It's add step. I've added a step, okay? So you can see it's a custom step right there. And you can go into the advanced editor if you wanna rename it. Let's see, you can right click here. You can rename it here too also. Doesn't matter, I don't care, right? What I'm gonna do is, check this out. I'm gonna say value.nativequery, just like that. I'm gonna open up my parentheses, get rid of that. And that's gonna be my source, right? That's the previous step. And I'm gonna just write a query. Select star from PBI underscore internet sales. Just like that, close this off, click away. There's my data. And so if I go here and I right click, there's my query folding. There's an indication that it's happening. Now, what happens if I do something? What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna add a filter. One. So I'm gonna do a transformation, right click, that's an indication that query folding may not be happening. That's not a guarantee, but that's an indication because that button is disabled. If you want to verify it, you should go and take a look on your source to see what queries Power BI is sending. It's not working. I verified query folding is broken in this case. Okay. How do I fix it? And so for a long time, Adam and I would tell people don't do this because you can't enable query folding. Well, what you can do is if you go back to that custom one step, go into the formula bar, or you can go into the advanced editor. This accepts a couple of parameters. We're gonna paste null here, and Chris Webb talks a lot of details about this value.nativequery function. But all we're gonna do is watch this, enable folding equals true. And some of you guys may be sitting there, that's not gonna work. Watch this. And all I'm gonna do is click away, give it some time to think. Let's go to this next step, right click on it. Is it gonna fold? Look at that, right? Poof, it folds. Query folding works. Just by adding this property, taking these few steps, now if I inject a native query, and there's lots of times people have no choice. They have no access to the source and they need to provide their own native query. But you know what was remarkable about this is my refresh was so much faster with that native query. Let me show you. So using Field CMarks, visualize your refresh report without folding. It took about 9 seconds. There was 92,000 rows that I pulled in, and it was pulling in about 9,400 rows per second. Now, how much faster do you think it was when I enabled folding? Let me show you. So if I go here with folding, it only took 3 seconds, a third of the time, and it processed more than 3 times the number of rows per second. Are you kidding me? I can speed up my refreshes for these native queries? Possibly. You need to test this out. It depends on your backend source. It depends on all the transformations. It depends on a lot of things, but it possibly can help. And I think everyone should give this a try that's using native queries as a source for their Power BI desktop. Okay, what do you guys think? Did you know about this? Have you tried this? Do you have any questions, comments? You know what to do. Post it in the comments below. If it's your first time visiting the Guy in the Cube channel, hit that subscribe button. If you like my video, give me a big thumbs up. As always, from Adam and myself, thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next video.